Good afternoon. Today we will study concrete technology. In concrete technology, today we will study about fresh concrete, hardened concrete, water cement ratio, and curing of concrete. So let's start with fresh concrete. What does a fresh concrete means? The fresh concrete is a concrete where we will mix the constituent of concrete such as cement, water, aggregate, fine and coarse. And when we mix it, we mix it with some water cement ratio, and upon mixing it and washing it properly, we'll get the end result, which will be fresh concrete. And what are the properties of fresh concrete? So workability and consistency, these are the major properties of fresh concrete. Workability is one of the physical parameters of concrete, which affects the strength and durability as well as the cost of labor and appearance of the finished product. So workability is the major property of the fresh concrete, which affects the durability. And durability, as per the definition, is the satisfactory result which an end product or finished product will give, which will which that product can be used for the desired purpose. Concrete is said to be workable when it is easily placed and compacted homogeneously, that is without bleeding or segregation. Bleeding is a phenomenon where all the when the constituent of concrete are mixed, upon mixing, when the water is mixed or water cement ratio will be in excess in a given volume, then bleeding takes place. In that bleeding, water will be separated from the rest of the constituents, and then the water and the cement mixed in water will wash out. Segregation is a phenomenon where when you mix a concrete or a polished constituent, the cement paste will be so much diluted that it will not act. It will not be the concrete will, the cement when mixed with water will not produce that much of CSS gel, which is an adhesive, and will not join, or the cohesion between the constituent will not be as much proper, and the constituent will be separated from each other. So that phenomenon is known as segregation. Unworkable concrete needs more work or effort to be compacted in place. Also, honeycombs or pockets will be formed and visible when you will work with an unworkable concrete. Fresh concrete definition. By definition, the property of fresh concrete is indicated by the amount of useful internal work required to fully compact the concrete without bleeding or segregation in the finished product. So this is the actual definition. The text definition of the fresh concrete. Factors affecting workability, which is a major property of fresh concrete: water content in a concrete mix, amount of cement and its property, aggregate bleeding. How water content? Water content, as I told earlier, when you mix more amount of water in the concrete mix, then segregation or bleeding can take place. That's why water content is a major factor affecting workability. Amount of cement and its properties. If you mix different cement, such as for example, if you prepare a mix of ordinary Portland cement and as sample one, and sample two is prepared by the, let's say, high alumina cement, then between these two mixes, the amount of cement will vary and the quality of cement will also vary. And depending upon the property of the cement will be different. So when you prepare a mix, the properties will be of properties of both of the sample will be different from each other. Next is aggregate grading. If you are not having the proper grading, grading is the sample, the size of the aggregate you are taking, the size of the coarse aggregate and the size of the fine aggregate. The size of coarse aggregate is taken, and the aggregate size will decide the size of the fine aggregate, which will fill the voids created by the coarse aggregate. In that sand or fine aggregate will be filled to fill up the pores remaining. In that again the cement will occupy the remaining space, void spaces, and at the end water will be there. So that hole will be, the whole structure is known as matrix structure. That's why aggregate grading is very much important. Nature of aggregate particles such as shape, surface, texture, porosity, etc. So as I said, if aggregate is important grading, then shape, surface, texture, porosity is also equally important. Next is temperature of the concrete mix. If you have more temperature, more will be the water evaporation, and there will be less water cement ratio, and then the various distress will take place in concrete. Next is humidity of the environment. If it is too humid, then the water cement ratio which is there, and you have added the water cement ratio, there may be a chance of slight increment of water cement ratio, and in that water cement ratio the property will be different of that mix, cyber mix. Mode of compaction. Mode of compaction is how you are compacting it. You are compacting it with a needle vibrator, you are compacting it with a plate vibrator. Compacting is how you are compacting, and the way you will compact mechanically or manually, it will change, or it will have its factor in concrete making. Method of placement of concrete. So in how you are placing the concrete, you are placing with the hydraulic pump, or you are placing with the manually with the help of the levers. So that will also will have its effects. Method of transportation of concrete. How you are carrying the concrete? You are carrying it RMC, or you are carrying in some other vehicle. So it will have its own effect. Now, how to improve the workability of concrete? So how can we improve the workability of the concrete? We can increase the water cement ratio to increase the workability of the concrete. Increase the workability by definition means the ease with which you can mix a concrete, transport a concrete to the desired site and place successfully. That is the basic definition of workability. So water cement ratio plays a vital role. Increased size ratio of aggregate will have its own role. So for example, the plum concrete which have an aggregate size of 160 mm will be having good workability than a lower aggregate size concrete. Use well-rounded and smooth aggregate. So if you are using well-rounded and smooth aggregate, the workability will be more, because the addition, if it is a rounded one and smooth, it will have the friction, or what to say, the grip between the aggregate will be less, and it can easily be in touch with each other, and it will go a bit more viscous than a rough textured aggregate. That's why the workability will be good. Increase the mix time. If you increase the mix time, with the increased mix time, the concrete workability may increase. Increase the mixing temperature. If you increase the mixing temperature, with the increase in temperature, the workability may increase. It may increase, not increase, it depends upon the circumstances in which you are preparing concrete. Use non-porous and saturated aggregate. So it will have its effect, or it will increase the durability, the workability, with addition of air entering admixtures. So with addition of air entering admixtures will behave like a bearing, and in a cross section of layer, it will behave like a roller. In a bearing, roller bearing, and the layers will slide upon each other very smoothly. That's why the overall workability will be increased. Admixtures. Chemical admixtures are added to concrete in very small amounts, mainly for air entrainment, reduction of water or cement content, plasticizing of fresh concrete mixtures, or to control the setting time of the concrete. So admixture plays a vital role when you have to maintain the water cement ratio and the workability both. That's why chemical admixtures play vital role in fresh concrete. These admixtures can be broadly categorized as superplasticizer, accelerator, retarders, water reducers, and air entraining admixture. Plasticizer will increase the workability with very less water cement ratio. Accelerators will accelerate the initiation time of the cement. Retarders will retard the initiation time of concrete. Water reducers will add in the concrete. The concrete will be needing less water than cement ratio than it is needing prior without adding water reducers. And air entraining mixture. Once you add the air entraining admixtures, they will increase the workability of the concrete. Super plasticizers are added to reduce the water requirement by 15-20% without affecting the workability, leading to a high strength and dense concrete. So, if you are adding super plasticizer admixtures, then the water will be reduced by 15-20% of the total volume of the sample, without affecting the workability, leading to a high strength or dense concrete. So the result end up with high quality concrete and dense concrete, and durability will be also more. Superplasticizers are liner polymers containing sulfonic acid groups attached to the polymer at regular intervals. The commercial formulation can be sulfonated melamine formaldehyde. Condensed states, sulfonated naphthalene, formaldehyde, condensed, etc. These are the examples of the commercially available super plasticizers. The main purpose of super plasticizers is to produce a flowing concrete with very high slump in the given range of 175 to 200 mm, which can be used effectively in densely reinforced structures. The increased slump of concrete depends upon dosage. So, if you are if the slump is more, the slump, what is slump? First of all, if the fall, this fall, with respect to the horizontal top length is more, the slump value will be more, and that slump value will be written as like this, 175 mm up to 200 mm. So if that value, slump value is more, obviously the workability will be more, because there is that slump, that water cement in that water cement should be more, or the consistency of that concrete slurry will be more, and that depends upon dosage also. If you are adding more dosage, then the more workability will be there, type and type of super plasticizer, which type of you are adding. If you are adding high quality super plasticizer, then further you may be needed less water cement ratio, and the minimum water cement ratio which can be used with using super plasticizer is 0.25. As per the IS code, you should have at least 0.25 water cement ratio along with super plasticizer. Accelerators are added to reduce the setting time of the concrete, thus helping early removal of forms, and are also used in the cold weather concrete. So, accelerators which reduces the setting time of the concrete. It reduces the setting time of the concrete and thus helping early removal of forms. So, it can reduce the setting time, so the initial time will be very less. And the less you can remove early, the shuttering and all this you can remove early. This accelerator can be used more in cold weather compared to, because in cold weather, if you have less time, the setting time of the cement will be less, you can move early. The shuttlings you can move there. First of all, calcium chloride is the most commonly used accelerator for concrete. So, calcium chloride is the most commonly used accelerators for concreting. The use of calcium chloride in reinforced concrete can promote corrosion. Why? Because of the chloride attack. With the chloride attack, the corrosion activity within a concrete structure will be increased. So we have to deal with that also. So, but with respect to the reducing setting time, the corrosion will be comparatively far less, and that can be compensated. So as people are getting aware of the corrosion activities, they are going interested in using chloride free extractor. So as people are now aware of the situation that using calcium chloride, the steel will get corroded and in a long time will get degraded, and overall life of the structure will become less. So with the growing awareness of this distress or this problem, now people are using chloride free accelerators. Retarders are added to increase the setting time by slowing down the hydration of cement. So retarders, what retarders will do, they will increase the setting time, they will lengthen the setting time by slowing down the hydration of cement. So hydration reaction will be slowed down by and as the hydration reactions slow down, overall production of CSH gel will be slowed down, and resulting in the slowing down of adhesive production, which is CSH, and overall the slowing down of the setting time of the concrete. They are preferred in places of high temperature. Where is a high temperature, you can use this and you can delay the setting time. Retarders consist of organic and inorganic agents. Organic retarders include unrefined calcium, sodium and ammonium salts, lignosulfonic acid, hydrocarboxylic acid, and these are the examples of carbohydrates. So inorganic retarders include oxides of lead, zinc, phosphate and magnesium salts. These are the examples of the retarders we use. These are common retarders. Most retarders also act as water reducers. They are called water reducing retarders, thus resulting in greater compressive strength due to the low water cement ratio. So if you have low water cement ratio, as we have said, the water reducer, they reduce the water amount, or the water cement ratio required by concrete will be less. So this is how it reduces the water content, and that will result in the increase in compressive strength of the concrete. Water reducing admixtures are added to concrete to achieve certain workability in the form of slump at low water cement ratio. A concrete with specified strength at lower cement content, thus saving on the cement. So a concrete with specified strength, which are given strength at lower cement content, if you are getting this by adding water reducing, if you are getting the specified strength with the use of less cement, then it is actually a saving of the cement. First, the water reducers are mostly used in hot weather. So these water reducers are mostly used in hot weather concreting and to paint pumping. So when you are using in hot water only, when you are using the pumping method of pumping the concrete, placing into the given mold, there you can use water reducers where the temperature are high. Water reducers plus cells are hygroscopic powder, which can entrain air into concrete. So they can also entrain air into concrete, resulting in more workability. Air entraining admixture. Entrain small air bubbles in the concrete, which act as a bearings. These elbows act as a rollers or bearings, thus improving the workability and are also very effective in freeze-thaw cycle, as they provide a cushion effect on the expanding water in the concrete in cold climate. So what exactly freeze-thaw cycle is? Freeze-thaw cycle is a cycle in which if we have made a structure with a definite water content in it, the water which is being settled in onto the surface of the porous surface of the structure in the daytime, where the temperature will be high. Once it will, the temperature will fall in night, that water will condense into ice. And with a equal, with a, if a liquid have a given volume, in that when the liquid freezes to ice, the volume will increase, and that volume will increase in volume will force the nearby area, will force itself in the nearby area, or will occupy more space, will try to occupy more space. In that, it will damage the structure. So this is how freezing thawing cycle will be damage the structure. And to avoid that, or to prevent that also, we are adding air and drainage admixtures. Air and drainage admixtures are compatible with most admixture. Care should be taken to prevent them from coming in contact during mission. So we should not, we should be very careful by placing this entering admixtures, and we should prevent ourselves incoming contact with that air entering admixtures. Generally, the effectiveness of both types of plasticizers are dependent on the ambient temperature condition, and thus in summer the amount of plasticizer to be used to cater for the same degree of increase in the plasticity can be more than the quantity to be used in the winter. So this is how the effectiveness of plasticizers are can be chopped up. Now next is hardened concrete. So these are the mechanical properties of hardened concrete. First is durability. What is durability? It's the ability to maintain satisfactory performance over an extended service life. So durability in simple terms can be said as, it is if you prepare a structural element, it should perform satisfactorily for the lifespan it is being designed. That is known as durability of that element. Second is compressive strength. Compressive strength, as all we know, that compressive strength is a characteristic compressive strength of concrete which comes at after 28 days, and that is one of the mechanical property, because we can test it in the lab on universal testing machine, and we can prepare a mold, we can prepare a cube of 150 or 250 mm and load it with the aspartame and standard codes, and we can find out the compressive strength of the concrete. We all know concrete is good in compressive strength, that's why this property is very, very important in under mechanical properties. Next is tensile strength. We all know that concrete is very fragile, and it have almost, what to say, very less tensile strength compared to the compressive strength of the concrete. So that's why tensile strength, we generally doesn't do test tensile strength. So, or if we can use a split tensile test. We do split tensile test to know exactly the tensile strength of the concrete. Next, flexural strength. What flexural strength do? It measures, it is a measure of tensile strength of concrete expressed in megapascal and determined by center point loading method and 3-point loading method. So we will prepare a beam of specified length and the cross section, and if we place a beam under the machine, flexural strength testing machine, the load will, the method of center point load will place the load point load on the center of the beam, and we'll get the results in terms of megapascal. And in 3-point loading method, we'll put the point load on the two sides, and we'll divide the entire length of the sample beam in three equal parts, and on the two equal part exactly at the same distance from the both edges, we'll put the two point load on that, and we'll get the results in terms of megapascal. As I have already told, concrete is used for compressive loads. Compressive strength is easily obtained by the UTM machine. It is good measure of all other properties. So Compressive strength is the major strength for which we use concrete, and it's a good measure of all other properties. If a concrete is having good compressive strength, then for sure it has it somewhere in the structure. It is having good properties in all directions. So strength of the concrete in general, the strength of the concrete specimen prepared, cured and tested under specific conditions at given age, that's 7, 14 and 28. This is depends upon the water cement ratio and degree of compression. It also depends upon the compressive strength, depends upon the water cement ratio and degree of compression. Apart from many other factors, the primary factors which are water cement ratio and degree of compression. It does have, because the concrete made up is a matrix structure which is made up of many different fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, cement, water cement ratio, all these things. Apart from these two, there are many other factors on which concrete compressive strength depends, but these are primary factors: water cement ratio, degree of compaction, how you are compacting the concrete, and all these things. And these are the compressive strength, the y-axis, and the aero test we do. So these are the how it represent with respect to the water cement ratio, different water cement ratio. And as you can see, if we are increasing the water cement ratio, the overall compressive strength is increasing. Now, on the if we plot a graph on water cement ratio on the y-axis and compressive strength on the y-axis, we can see a curve like exponential curve. If at less water cement ratio, you will have more value of compressive strength, and the more water cement ratio, you will have very less value. So it decreases exponentially with increase in water cement ratio. This is durability. Durable concrete, as I said, is one which withstands effect and degree of effect for its life, the effects of surface conditions to which it is subjected. Factors affecting durability: external is environment, because we make durable concrete so that the element can withstand for its entire life, facing all the environmental factors for which it is designed. For let's say for the present and for the future environment also. Second, internal. What can be internal? Permeability, characteristics of ingredients, airborne system. These are the basic. Externally, it is environment, but internally also, how much permeability it has, what are the characteristics of ingredients which you have added to make the concrete, and air voids, how much air void left in the concrete element. These are also affects the durability of concrete. So these are the how it is a the vectorial representation of the durability of the concrete. Now, if you have to classify the external and internal, physical, external causes are physical, chemical, mechanical. Leaching is one. Actions of sulfates, sea water, these are the environmental factors, OPC, LSC, reverberating cement, and all these things. So, if you are the summary of this all external is that when you place a concrete, you must know in which environment you want to place that concrete element. If you are placing a concrete element in a marine environment, in coastal area where you have the air which has the content of salts, then that salt, it will be sodium chloride, and then that chloride will attack the structure and it will corrode the steel. So you must then use a concrete or prepare a concrete mix which is the resistant, or you can it will be resistant to the weather, that weather, marine weather. So this is how the external causes will affect, and to prevent it, how we will deal with that problem. Now next is water cement ratio. Water cement ratio. The water cement ratio is the ratio of the weight of water to the weight of the cement used in a concrete mix, and has an important influence on the quality of the concrete produced. A lower water cement ratio leads to higher strength and durability, but may make the mix more difficult to place. Placement difficulties can be resolved by using plasticizers or superplasticizers. This is how, which I have already told in fresh concrete, how superplasticizers are used to lower down the water cement ratio. The concept about cement tissue was developed by Duff A. Abraham and first published in 1918. For every pound, or like for every kilogram, or any unit in which we are taking cement or concrete, of cement, about 0.25 pounds or 0.25 kg and whatever with the unit of cement of water is needed to fully complete the hydration reaction. This requires a water cement ratio of 1:4 often given as proportion 0.25. So for completely reaction, hydration reaction, we need only 0.25% of 1:4 what you say, cement water ratio. However, a mix with a water cement ratio of 0.25 may not thoroughly and may not flow well enough. That means it will hydrate 0.25, water cement ratio of 0.25 will hydrate the concrete completely, but it will not be workable. And if it not will be workable, then we cannot just place it to the desired model. We cannot place it to the desired element, and then there will be a problem. So to avoid that, we will increase the workability, and that can be increased by adding water or can be increased by adding admixture, especially super plasticizer with keeping the water cement ratio as 0.25 or a constant value. More typical water cement ratios of 0.4 are used in common. For higher strength concrete, lower water cement ratio is required. Higher strength and durability with high qualities. If you go in the strength wise and quality wise concrete, higher strength, high mix concrete, design mix concrete will have more super plasticizer with less cement ratio. Too much water will result in segregation of sand, aggregate components from the cement paste. Also, water that is not consumed by the hydration reaction, so there will be extra water. And that may keep the concrete as it hardens, resulting in microscopic pores, and that microscopic pores will decrease the durability and in turn decrease the life of the structure. A mix with too much water will experience more shrinkage because there will be more water, there will be more evaporation of water when it will be cured or kept in an environment where there will be more temperature. As the excess water leaves through evaporation, resulting in internal cracks and visible fractures. So this is how more water will affect the concrete. In 1997, Uniform Building Code specifies a maximum of 0.5 water to cement ratio when concrete is exposed to freezing and thawing in the moist condition or to de-icing chemicals, and a maximum of 0.45 water to cement ratio for concrete in severe and very harsh cement sulfate conditions like mining conditions. So this is how the building code specifies. Now last is curing of concrete. Why do we do curing? We do curing to maintain a temperature within the concrete element so that it will continue to produce the CSH gel, calcium silicate hydrate gel. And that gel behaves as an adhesive which will add all these constituent in a single unit, and it will try to keep that heterogeneous structure of a concrete into a homogeneous that we have initially assumed. Curing is the process in which the concrete is protected from loss of moisture and kept within a reasonable temperature range to produce, so that it can produce CSH gel. This process results in concrete with increased strength and decreased permeability. Why? Because it will produce more CSH gel, more adhesiveness will be there, and that will bind the constituent with each other properly. Curing is also a key player in mitigating the cracks, which can severely affect the durability. It will also lower down the cracks, which can severely affect the durability. A concrete element is expected to last a certain number of years. In order to meet this expected service life, it must be able to withstand the structural loading and fatigue. So this is how we have to just take care of the curing. The duration and the type of curing plays a big role in determining the required material necessary to achieve the high level of quality. Curing is the process in which the concrete is protected from loss of moisture and kept within a reasonable temperature range. And this is how a curing will. This is why the curing is the most important thing once the concrete is prepared and molded. So with the with this curing of we ends with curing of concrete, and for future topics in concrete energy we will start in next class. Thank you.